Send
Nathan.
word out and open that
Yes.
smart.
Good. Now. Break a leg. I'll see you after the show.
Nathan.
Hey, Nathan's dad is some asshole, huh?
I know. I wish he'd just go away and leave him alone.
Nathan's dad sucks. But you should be careful what you wish for when it comes to parents.
Oh, Chloe, I wasn't thinking. I'm sorry.
For what? You didn't kill my dad. Or did you? That was a joke.
I know. Your dark sense of humor reminds me a lot of Nathan's. Actually, the two of you are really similar.
What the hell does that mean?
I'm serious. You're both artistic and surprisingly sensitive. You've been through a lot, and a lot of people unfairly judge you for it. I think you stood up for Nathan yesterday because you know what he's going through. Nathan's hurt and he needs help. But whenever I try to help him, it always seems to make things worse. If you were Nathan right now, what would you want me to do?
When I'm super pissed, the last thing I want is someone trying to calm me down. But maybe it's what I need. Nathan acted like he didn't want our help yesterday. But trust me, he was glad we did.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. That's actually super helpful.
Well, I hope that's the right thing to do.
Thanks for your help, Chloe. Here's hoping.
Boys' changing tent. Thanks, but no thanks. Hey, Hayden.
Address me as Ferdinand, good lady.
All right. Hey, go fuck yourself.
Super lame, Chloe. I mean, super lame, fair maiden.
Great, method acting.
Really? Thanks. My spirits, as in a dream, are all bound up. My father's loss, the weakness which I feel.
I should find Rachel.
S.G. Must be Steph. Sucks that she has to miss this. S.G. Must be Steph. Sucks that she has to miss this.
No, I don't want to do anything. I don't want to.
Rachel?
Okay, what's the two clubs for?
Whatever that was, it was shady as shit. I need to find whatever Victoria slipped into that drink. Adding putting on makeup to the long list of reasons I wouldn't be caught dead on stage. Victoria Chase is actually a pretty talented photographer. What is that? Muscle relaxers?
Coming, Rachel.
Oops.
Hurry now before your tea gets. What are you doing here? This area is for cast and crew only.
I'm here to support Rachel.
How nice.
I want to make sure she's relaxed before the show.
Whatever. Oh, Rachel Amber. It was customary among the thespians of ancient Greece for the understudy to offer hot tea to the lead actress on opening night. As a way of showing appreciation for her tutelage. It is in that spirit that I offer you this beverage. May it help to reveal the essence of your talents for all to see.
Wow. That, thanks. Hold up. Did you hear that?
Hear what? I didn't hear anything.
Oh, I hear it now. It sounds like Mr. Keaton's calling for you.
He is? Oh, he probably wants my thoughts on the set dressing. Okay, don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
What's going on? Bitch, dosed your teeth.
That is the least surprising thing ever. What should we do?
Problem solved.
Damn, Chloe Price. What would I do without you?
Have super relaxed muscles, I guess.
Mr. Keaton's busy with Nathan. I'm sure he'll call on my aesthetic sensibility soon. In the meantime, let us drink. Oh, make sure you drink it all. Your instrument will thank you.
I am so grateful to have such a kind and caring friend as you, Victoria.
Aw, samesies.
Samesies too.
Anyway, I'll see you out there. Break a leg.
So, that happened?
Just when I thought this day couldn't get any batshit crazier.
Sweet pardon, we're ruined. The show is ruined.
That was quick.
My dear young artists, a misfortune most unkind has befallen us. Juliet is waylaid. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel. Would that she could but manifest on her master's whim as a true spirit. Alas, devoid of an understudy, the situation is a dire one indeed. I'm afraid we may have to cancel. Truly, we are a cursed lot. Even my prodigious imagination cannot conceive of a worse turn of fate.
Mr. Creighton, I have revelations to reveal. Rachel Amber is on drugs. Look at her. Her face is so blurry and pretty. Oh, she's clearly been drugged. I mean, drugged herself. She loves drugs. Don't you? Oh!
Touché, fates. Touché.
What? No.
Mr. Keaton.
No.
Chloe could step in for Juliet.
No fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
The romantic.
She's the right fit for Juliet's costume.
She is indeed. Tell me, my dear, have you ever acted before?
Hell no.
She's being modest. We play improv games all the time. And she's fantastic at it.
My dear, what if I told you that the entire fate of the production rests upon your slender shoulders?
I'd say you're super fucked.
Chloe, please. For me.
Damn it. I can't believe Rachel's talked me into this.
When life gives you lipstick, use it to tag shit.
Got it.
Just one more.
I seriously have to memorize all of this? Thanks, Rachel.
Oh, yeah. Jesus, I'm not gonna do this. Sure, I'll do the same thing as, freaking heated. I'll, find a guide on YouTube or something. I'll find a guy. Not really on YouTube, but on Google, because I don't know, man. I'm not gonna remember all that. No. Will it load on my phone? Well, it's just taking forever. Holy. Okay. Feel free to improve.
By accident most strange, bountiful fortune hath mine enemies brought to the shore.
I boarded a kingship held empty.
Here, cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. Tis a good dullness, and give it way. I know thou canst not choose. Come away, servant. Come.
Ah, shit. I'm on.
That's you.
I am ready now.
Get up there.
Approach, my Ariel. Come.
Damn it. No problem. I've got this. I just walk to Rachel and say my line.
All hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure.
Most fearless, generous spirit, hast thou performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?
Oh, that's so
I've boarded
cool.
The king's ship. In every cabin, that, I flamed amazement.
Timer.
The fire Jesus and God. Cracks of sulphurous roaring, the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves tremble.
My brave spirit, who was so firm, so constant, that this coil would not infect his reason.
Not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped from his ship and cried.
Oh, his empty.
Cried, hell is empty, and all the devils are here.
Yes!
But are they, Ariel, safe?
All right. I guess this is when I'm supposed to walk somewhere.
Oops.
Not a hair perished, and as thou badest me, I have dispersed them about the isle.
In troops.
In troops.
Bravo.
Ariel, thy charge exactly is performed. But there's more work.
Is there more toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised.
How now? What is't thou canst demand?
Enough already. Oh, one or the two. Liberty or equality?
My, equality?
No creature may come near to equal Prospera. That lies beyond my power to bestow.
My liberty.
Thy liberty? Nay, this most of all I will not grant.
That's not her line, is it? What's going on?
But thou assured my freedom, didn't thou?
I never said how dearly I hold thee. My habit's been to keep my soul well draped. Most loyal spirit, companion, and friend, is acting in my service not replete with excitement, amusement, and delight?
Of course, mistress. Most truly it is so.
Mr. Key, they're way
Shh.
Off script. It's magical.
Then why, I pray you, wish you to be free?
Excitement
ages quickly. And I fear if we set out in search of new, fun, you'll tire of me. And, then I'll be alone.
I have thee in my grasp. I will not bend. I will not see thee flying forth alone. The envy would be more than I could bear.
So come with me. Is that not in thy power?
Spirit, take my hands. Most faithful friend, for but a little longer I beseech. Continue in thy service to my schemes, and when they are complete, I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. I'll seek to make thy happiness so great that e'en the name of liberty is forgot.
Okay.
What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Say yes!
Yes, I am most pleased. Your duty done for now, so go forth hence with haste. I've work to do.
Thanks, Chloe.
Well done. An admirable effort. And the ending? Absolutely transformative. I am humbled.
No problem.
What the hell just happened?
Victoria and the other scene?
Shake it off. Come on. We'll visit Caliban, my slave.
Tis a villain, sir. I do not love to look on.
He does make our fire, fetch in our wood. What ho! Slave! Caliban! Come forth, I say!
As wicked do as e'er my mother brush, with raven's feather from unwholesome fen, drop on you both! A southwest blow on ye, and blister you all o'er.
Thou poisonous slave, got by the devil himself, filth as thou art, I have lodged thee in mine own cell, till thou didst seek to violate the honor of my child.
Oh ho, oh ho! Would it had been done! Thou didst prevent me, I had peopled else this isle with Calibans.
Fetch us in fuel, and be quick. So, slave, hence.
Where should this music be? In the air or the earth?
This play is super intense.
What is it? A spirit? It carries a brave form, but it is a spirit.
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and hath such senses as we have.
I will resist such entertainment.
Put thy sword up, traitor!
Do you love me?
O heaven, O earth, bear witness to this sound. I, beyond all limit of what else in the world, do love, prize, honor you.
His tears run down his beard like winter's drops from eaves of reeds.
Go release them, Ariel. My charms I'll break, their senses I'll restore, and they shall be themselves. Now my charms are all overthrown, and what strength I have's mine own. Pray, release me from my bands, with the help of your good hands.
I don't understand who that is, though. Is that Victoria? Or, is that, Dana? No. See, Dan is right there, so I'm guessing Victoria's there. But wouldn't she know that, she's, been... That...
Wasn't that fun?
We
You're
switched,
so dead, yeah?
Thing.
How dead? Hella dead.
I kinda know, remember the third episode now of this. Not too fondly, but I remember it.
Oh my god, Keaton's face behind you when you walked on stage? I was shitting myself.
In the dead of night, I'll meet you.
He was shitting himself. That dude owes
in
me.
In the morning light, you wake up next to me. Like a dream come true, I'll take you where I roam. And follow you.
My dear, what if I told you that the entire fate of our production rests upon your slender shoulders? I've never had an experience like that on stage. Yeah, right? You were... No, you. Like, seriously. I love nights after a show. Is it always like this? Oh, totally. It's such a high. No more nerves, just the adrenaline. So, first timer, are you proud of yourself? Yeah, I feel really awesome. If you told me this morning I'd be this happy tonight, you've gone through so much shit today. Right now's pretty good. Okay, the whole show was good. I admit it. Yeah. It was magical.
Something sick in here.
Let's leave. For real.
For real, huh?
You said you wanted to skip town and never look back. Like I said last night, let's do it.
I know. I've been thinking about that all day. But that was...
Don't say it was just a crazy thought. You mean it. I can tell. You want this.
Yeah, but, like, eventually.
Let's go. Now. Didn't we already agree on stage?
We can't just...
Why not?
Fine then, drama queen. Where are we going?
You tell me. What uniquely twisted location does Chloe Price plus Rachel Amber equal?
Why don't you show me L.A.?
Perfect. 60 degrees every night. You and me on the Santa Monica Pier. Gorging on food truck food.
smoking up, looking at the moon shining on the waves. And a beautiful blonde man will sit next to us and smile at you.
Yeah, okay.
He'll say, I like your eyes. And I'll say, back off. She's with me.
You're full of shit.
I love this time of night. Don't you just feel like everything's possible?
Rachel, stop. If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
For fuck's sake! I've never been more serious in my life. Chloe, what would it take to convince you?
How about, Oh.
Is that convincing enough?
Yeah. Holy shit. Right? What is this stuff?
I think it's a sign. I think we should leave tonight.
Really?
If you want to, I'm ready. Let's go sneak some clothes and stuff in my house.
I would guess it's no, but it's probably Ash. From those fire.
That sounds perfect.
Because I'm pretty sure BC has that. Well, around Burton or on a cusp, if whatever. Because they burn a big section of the forest when they're all in dry season, when the trees all dry off. And I think they have an ash, I think it rains ash then. Or... Or I could be wrong.
Oh, you're home. Rose, Rachel's home. And she brought her new friend.
Our star returns. You're just in time. Dinner's almost ready. Chloe, was it?
It was, but that was before I was expelled. Now, it's that girl who used to go here. What was her name again? All one word.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to bring up any sore subjects.
Who's sore?
Rachel, honey, you were resplendent tonight.
Thanks.
Chloe, you must join us for dinner tonight.
She must?
I must?
Of course.
I made chicken a la king. I'm sure you both acted up quite the appetite.
Yeah, no thanks. I'm more of a burger a la king kind of gal.
She's funny, this one.
I'm aware.
Chloe, I know we didn't exactly meet each other at our best this morning, but with you and Rachel becoming such fast friends, I insist you join us for dinner. Don't you agree, Rachel?
Yes, of course. Chloe, would you join us for dinner, please?
Of course.
Great. I just need to wash off. Then I'll be right down.
Don't be long. In meantime, perhaps you can help me with the table, Chloe?
Sure thing, Mrs. Amber.
Okay, I'm gonna go pack. After dinner, we can make our break. You cool down here?
Totally. Your parents love me.
They're good at coming off that way, but don't let your guard down. And, Chloe, we just need to make it through dinner. Try not to say anything that, you know...
that I would normally say.
Exactly.
Just some quality time with the Ambers. What could possibly go wrong? Something about this photo doesn't seem right. I should fix it. Can't tag this while Rachel's mom is right there. She totally bust me.
Oh, I've distracted.
Hey there, Mrs. Amber.
Chloe, I'm so glad you're joining us tonight.
So, Rachel was pretty awesome tonight.
Yes, she was. Though, to be fair, she's pretty awesome every night. I wish I were half as driven when I was her age.
Me too.
I get the sense that you're a force of nature yourself. I can see why the two of you get along so well.
You can? Because it still seems crazy to me. Integrity, honesty, loyalty.
What?
It's on your lawn.
Oh, right. Sorry. I guess I'm still getting used to being an elected official's wife.
What's it like being married to the DA?
Much like being married to anyone else, I imagine.
But with a lot more secrets, right?
Secrets?
Like attorney-client privilege and all that.
Well, as district attorney, he brings cases against criminals on behalf of the state. He doesn't defend them.
Exactly how long has he... played,
what did you think
pretend
of the play?
To be
Rachel was typically
his
amazing,
wife,
but
because
I
don't...
liked The Tempest. What did you think of it?
Is she
to
pretending,
be honest,
or is she
only really read a
his
couple
wife?
Pages? Theater's not really my thing. I guess I'm not so into saying words someone else came up with.
Fair point. Then again, I'm not sure you can judge the entire art form based on the dead white man your curriculum focuses on.
Me too.
Damn. Shots fired, Shakespeare.
Is that evil?
So, you putting me to work or what?
Yes. If you could please take 4 plates from the cupboard and set them on the table.
What if I can't?
Excuse me?
You said if I could. Never mind.
You're a riot, Chloe.
All right, Chloe. You've set the table without ruining someone's marriage before. Piece of cake. Can't tag this while Rachel's mom is right there. She totally bust me.
Where is the...
Doing the play was bad enough without having to read about it afterwards. Hope Drew's okay, though. How to clear browser history, followed by a gap for all of yesterday? That's like cheating asshat 101. Poor Rachel. Hiya, Mr. Amber.
Chloe, what can I do for you?
Rachel.
Your daughter's pretty great.
Thank you. We're fond
it's
of her
like,
as well.
I know
you
I don't
feel
have
like
to
she's
talk
so awesome at everything that you just
I don't know,
shake
it's
her.
Just something...
Yeah.
There.
Me neither. So, you're a district attorney, huh?
I'm your district
and,
attorney.
So I can call you if I'm ever district arrested?
I found out
it was a
what
joke.
Is it?
Not a good one.
The
clearly.
Dragon's crown on this floor is on a separate trophy list.
I thought Rachel was perfectly cast.
By the way.
She certainly was. We're very proud of her. I had no idea they were going to do that.
Do what?
Well, I see.
I don't know. Kind of
sucks because I don't have the plan on
woman
for attacking yet, so.
I just meant the wizard part.
I suppose that's also true.
I.
Duty calls.
Don't really care. To be honest.
Chat, Mr. Amber.
Mm-hmm.
Liberate or literal. Okay.
Solved it. There's no puzzle to which swords isn't the solution.
Where are the plates?
Glasses. Damn, the ambers are fancy as shit. Never realized that getting drunk could be so complicated.
Okay. I really
Rachel and I both
don't
had
know
great childhoods. Mine just ended a little before hers, I guess. Everything about this house is nicer, cleaner, better, and more expensive than mine. Which isn't saying much, but still. I should stay down here until Rachel is ready.
Okay, let's go on a freaking hunt for these plates. Oh, they're probably in the freaking... But then,
no
why
skeletons.
The hell were the cups?
Lots of shiny dishes, though. bringing stuff to the table with you.
Yeah, I don't know why that's the first place I don't know. Well, I guess that's the first place I didn't look because, the glasses were in the freaking, China cabinet or whatever that is. So I was just confused as shit. And I thought, what is the freaking place for somewhere else, but nope.
Yes, Chloe?
Plates? Check. Anything else?
Actually, could you be a dear and ask Mr. Amber what he'd like to drink with dinner?
I will be a dear. Talking to James. As long as I can avoid using the words cheating and scumbag, I should be fine.
Something else?
What's your vice, Mr. Amber?
I'm sorry?
Your wife wants to know what kind of drink you're having.
Ah, let's say sherry.
Okay. One, two, three, sherry.
Comical. Chloe, maybe you can help me understand something.
I'll give it a shot.
Rose and I, we're worried about Rachel. Yesterday was so unlike her. What do you suppose is going on?
Besides you, besides me.
Besides all my bad behavior rubbing off on her, you mean?
Another joke.
You tell me. It seemed like you and Wells were happy to believe that this morning.
And you were all too eager to play into our expectations. In my experience, that's a tactic people use to cover for someone else. Rachel is her own person. She's responsible for her actions. I'd be lying if I said I didn't have concerns about your friendship, but perhaps you're exactly who Rachel needs right now as she navigates the choppy waters of adolescence.
Thanks.
Okay, now let's do that. I really don't know.
Chloe?
It's not a hell of a lot. To be honest.
The boss man would like a sherry.
Thank you. The glasses are in the china cabinet. You can place one at his setting.
How am I supposed to get to China? Kidding. It's the fancy looking cabinet, right?
You got it.
Yes, Chloe?
So, am I crushing it?
This dinner would be taking literally minutes longer without you.
Crushing it. Can't tag this while Rachel's mom is
can
right
I do
there.
No.
She totally bust me.
I have to set the, set the glasses.
It's the triangle shaped one.
Basic shapes. Now you're speaking my language.
Basic. Do I have to sit this down first? I really just don't want to miss it.
She totally bust me.
Because if I miss it, I'm going to have to go all way back to the, okay, wipe your butt up. Am I done now?
Can't tag this. Well, Rachel's mom is right there. She totally bust me. So this is what normal looks like. It's somehow way more boring and way weirder than I imagined. It's crazy to picture Rachel growing up here and being happy here, at least before she met me. Duty calls. Hey, good chat, Mr. Amber.
Mm-hmm.
Why isn't he helping the frickin' set to kill a lazy asshole?
Yes, Chloe?
What else? Feel like I'm getting good at this.
Only one last step. As our guest, you may do the honor of lighting the candles. The lighter is in the...
It's cool. I've got my own.
Oh.
You never know when you'll need to light a candle. Right?
You are a paragon of preparedness.
Thanks. I think. Time to light some candles and bless this joint up a bit. Finally, Mrs. Amber has her back turned. Time to fix this photo.
There we go. I count directly. Dracula.
Good.
Rather than Frankenstein. Yay, I got him. Yep. Got him up.
Dinner will be ready in just a moment. Did you light the candles?
What's my objective? Light candles.
Something else?
Duty calls. Hey, good chat, Mr. Amber.
Mm-hmm.
How does he roll? Whatever. This is he rolls up his freaking his paper really freaking fast.
The Amber family and fire. What could possibly go wrong?
Oh, I'm glad I freaking put graffiti the newspaper before I lit the candles.
So, Chloe, are you and Rachel in any of the same classes?
I wish. Rachel's all honors. I'm still trying to get into remedial. What's it called? Vocabulary.
What about that fire?
Dinner's really good, Mom.
Thank you, Rachel. The way the fire spreads so fast, I've never heard of anything like it.
It's almost surreal. They say a fire like that could only come from a crime of passion.
Passion? What does that mean?
I don't know. You tell me. Because you're the DA, of course.
It's certainly troubling. The latest report from the commissioner's office suggests arson.
Arson? Why would anyone do that?
Any number of reasons. With everything going on in the world today, even a town like Arcadia Bay isn't immune to the ills of society.
I cannot imagine how difficult these last few years have been for you, Chloe. Now that you and Rachel have become friends, I want you to know that our home is always open to you.
Cool. Thanks.
Well said, dear. It's imperative in such troubled times as these that we remember what is most important to us. Family. Family's not merely a gift. It is a responsibility. As such, those we love must be cared for and never, ever taken for granted.
Yeah, that's super true. And also remember, Rachel, that even when shit's like the lamest ever, you can always run away from whatever's bothering you. As long as you just keep calm.
I don't understand.
An interesting philosophy, Chloe.
Yes, indeed. Not one that I would endorse, however. I favor confronting my problems head-on. By to each their own, I suppose.
Oh, fucking blow me.
Then when you press cancel,
Rachel.
Just shifts off. I distract.
Crap. I'm so clumsy. Rachel, can you come help me find another
fork? Chloe. I can't sit here and listen to this bullshit anymore.
Rachel!
Stop it, Dad. You're a hypocrite. Okay? I know. You lying, cheating piece of shit, motherfucker.
Excuse me?
We saw you yesterday at the Overlook.
James?
Kissing that woman.
James.
Rachel? Honey, whatever you saw or think you saw, I know it's hard, but I need you to trust me.
Think we saw? Are you trying to gaslight us? There's no thinking involved. We saw you locking lips with some other woman. Best part is, she and I use the same drug dealer.
That's enough. You are not welcome here or around my daughter any longer. I know exactly what kind of person you are from the moment I saw you, and I let my wife's compassion get the better of you.
Oh? What kind of person is
a
that?
A delinquent. A broken girl from a broken home.
That's enough, James. I will not have you continue to speak to her like this.
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth? Stop lying! Stop being a politician for one fucking minute! Can't you just be my dad?
He might.
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress.
Okay.